LeBron threw some shade, intentionally unintentional. Unintentionally intentional, maybe, or intentionally unintentionally, at Knicks point guard Frank Ntilikina, who is their first round draft pick in the most recent draft. He wanted to throw shade at Phil Jackson.
We think.
Yeah. That's what he said.
Yeah.
So originally he said that he felt like Dennis Smith Jr. should have been a Knick. Here's a piece of that interview.
The Knicks passed on a really good one, and Dallas got the diamond in the rough. He should be a Knick. It's gonna make some headlines, but he should be a Knick. But Dallas is definitely, I know they're excited that he didn't go there. So he's an unbelievable talent, athleticism. He's very poised to be his age. Can shoot the ball, can penetrate. He's gonna only get better and better with the opportunity that he's given here to play. You know, so Dallas got a good one. I've been known now. I've been with him for so long now. So I've been known as to how his talent level.
Talk about how big those shots.
Huh? That's fine.
Playing against the guy who's playing his 20th season with the Mavericks, can you tell us a little bit about the legacy of Dirk Nowitzki?
I think it speaks for itself. There's no reason for me to harp on it. I think you say the name Dirk, he goes by one name. You don't have to say his last name. Everybody knows what he's about, what he's brought to this league, what he's brought to this Mavericks franchise. So it's no reason.
And then he came back. And he said it wasn't supposed to be shade at Frank Ntilikina.
It's the same if I think Deshaun Watson should be a Brown. Doesn't mean that Myles Garrett is not going to be a great football player, but Deshaun Watson should have been our quarterback. It's the same thing. It's not you shitting on the next guy. It's just that you state what you see. That's all that is for clarification of people who just live in the box. And for Enos Kanter, who always got something to say, he says, I don't know what's wrong.
Enos Kanter came out and said that we're good with who we have, standing up for his player. Porzingis saying we're good with who we have. Very standard. It's something that Ben McAdoo's players don't want to do for him. So fortunately, Jeff Hornacek's players do want to do for him, is back their actual players and not just suspend Frank for being like, well, LeBron doesn't like you. Kind of like how Ben McAdoo handles the New York Giants secondary. Well, Aaron Rodgers doesn't like you. You're suspended. I'm going to kick you off the team for a minute.
Ben, so, what did you tell your team at halftime?
Is that what he did? It's like one of the things he did. So then he came back and he said it was supposed to be shade at Phil Jackson, not Frank. However, Rick and I are pretty much in agreement on this one. Like, there was no way to say that without it being shade at young Frank. And
right.
But there's an ulterior motive here. The Knicks play the Cavs tonight on Monday night. Obviously, that is part of this. It's obviously some play up for the game in itself.
Cavs are taking the subway.
Yeah, the Cavs are taking the subway. They were like uninterrupted. There's a guy in the uninterrupted video that LeBron is doing, like his live video from the subway.
Yeah.
He's sitting next to LeBron James. LeBron goes, oh, who's this guy? And the guy's like, please don't, sir. And he like walks away. I'm like, who could you, maybe he was trying to skip work. Maybe he was skipping work and he's like, shit, now I'm gonna be everywhere in the uninterrupted video. Maybe he was like away from his wife.
I'm thinking this
on the spot. Why else would you be upset?
I can't comment.
If you're in a LeBron James video.
So I didn't see it, but
you gotta
see it now.
So yeah, that happened, Rick. I mean, your thoughts on LeBron being LeBron. Are we talking about a nothing burger? Is this a disgrace to nothing burgers?
Or is this a cheeseburger? Which part is the nothing?
I don't know, the shade at Cape at Frank, the shade at Phil. The shade at
Okay.
The guy who ran him from the subway.
I still have to see that.
They're all wearing like hoodies too. It's great. I mean, come on, man. Like,
it's cool.
You telling me you wouldn't want to share a subway with the greatest player of all time and LeBron James, J.R. Smith in this instance?
It's like when Jay-Z rode the subway to his own show.
That's amazing.
And he was sitting next to that old lady and she was like, so what do you do? And he's like, oh, I'm a rapper.
Like, what do you
respect,
do?
Respect to
good for her.
You know, respect to
kind
you
lady.
Know the original Annie Got Your Gun.
Right.
So there's like a few points to this. Yeah, we're in agreement. You can't say Dennis Smith should be a Knick without throwing shade to anybody else that followed the Knicks pick, because what you are saying, a cause and effect of this, the cause, Dennis Smith should be a Knick. The effect is no other player is near the same talent or of the same ilk as Dennis Smith Jr. And even if he did not mention Frank Ntilikina's name, it doesn't matter. Yeah. He did not say Phil Jackson initially as well. And a lot of people have gone back to, well, and you can see the quotes right here, but the posse comment that Phil Jackson had, yeah, and then LeBron's response, that's cool. But like, you know what should have happened? Because now this has happened twice in the span of 7 days where LeBron has been called out for something and he backtracks. Yeah, similar to the mood thing on social media. So it seems like once he hears the roars from society, because again, as you mentioned previously, and I think it's a brilliant point, we don't have a lot to hate on LeBron.
There's nothing like, besides
if he leaves
social
you that
media.
Little itty bitty window, then people take advantage of it. And like, whatever, I'm not one of those people, but I will say that now this is twice in the span of 7 days where he has had to, Jason, backtrack what he has said. By saying something more or doing something more.
He's a hype man. Like, he just played the Mavs, so Dennis Smith was on his mind, and he's about to play the
Apparently
Knicks.
They're good friends, too. I should throw that
Dennis
in there.
Smith
according to, like, Slam Online or something. Dennis Smith and LeBron are good friends.
That's kind of cool. Good for Dennis Smith. Dennis good Smith and Dennis J. Smith. Cole are good friends. They're both from
Vietnam.
I really, again, I'm going to say it.
Yeah, your Dreamville shirt is getting a fuck ton of love, by the way.
Yeah,
the
this is a devoted shirt, but the Dreamville shirt has always got a lot of love. People do it for the Ville, which they should.
So,
they
okay,
should.
To rule down on this, did you think LeBron initially meant it to be Phil Jackson?
I'm suspicious, man.
I think he thought about it literally in the most simplistic form of like, bop, should have been a Nick, but didn't even think about how it could be.
I think he was
rooted with other players that follow.
I think it's organizational. I think he meant it towards the Knicks franchise, and then that gave him the umbrella to be like Phil or Dolan. Look, taking shots at Phil Jackson and James Dolan is in any of the Knicks organization.
We allow it.
It's our pastime.
We allow it.
Like, it's totally fine to take shots at the Knicks organization. But like, what did young Frank do? The guy, like, he's really quiet, you know? He's a good passer. He's got better numbers than a lot of the other point guards in the league. Rookie point guards in the league right now. He's not playing massive minutes. And he's just doing his job, and he's playing some defense. Like, there's no reason to disrespect young Frank. The difference is Dennis Smith, like, if you don't know who Dennis Smith is and you're watching the NBA this season, I don't know where you are. I think it would be very understandable if you said, I don't know who that guy Frank Ntilikina is for the Knicks. He's very quiet. That's fine. Dennis Smith, he makes sure you know where and when he's coming in, because it is a full-blown fly zone.